Thank you. Welcome to the performance. This performance includes sound descriptions before each song of the set, descriptions that describe the oral content for artistic and accessibility purposes. The descriptions were written by artist Andy Slater, and I encourage you to check out his work at www.thisisandyslater.net. Thank you to Travis Thatcher, The Bridge, and UVA Department of Music for having us. I hope you enjoy. I was a figure, hearing her call from the furthest point of the sulfuric shadow. She has her back to us. I sit by a candle and accompanied by the breath of the right hand, she turns to show her voice. The candle flame flickers with the presence of words that make the dark seem darker, the room seem endless, and her voice a physical structure. The cave of her mouth is supported by stalactites and mites. The calls resonate and rip through. They are conflicted. Some value their home, and some would die to escape. She proclaimed she was a figure when we interrupted her, but clearly is now a mountain in the lower mantle of the earth.
Thank you. What is weakness for you?
Weakness, gosh, that's so loaded. Yeah, it's not a word I think about that much, and I wonder why.
The end. Horizontal in the water out past the breakers, you receive the gift of a calm. It is so comforting it insists that you shut your eyes. Like a single gull in the sky, the warnings from a friend circle overhead. This is the end. The choice to ignore them was strictly yours to make. The feeling of water flooding your inner ear startles open your eyes. The bright blue perfect sky ushers in a slow motion white-capped green aqua tidal. Wound like a ball of yarn. It moves above you, hundreds of feet above you, directly above you, at a glacier's pace assimilating you. You are up within its body, moving through its strings like a parasite. The monstrous wave dispels its guests into the sky behind it and down into its wake, and it is now your turn to be purged.
Thank you.
form and flee at the pace of a 90-tick minute, the hourglass sits. Passive-aggressive reminders cast by benign eyes. Your doubts of their intentions build, stack by stack. Loose sand and stone slabs glue your body and anxiety together. Purple and red dust embers. The one speaking is clearly controlling the flatlining sands. Vibrations on the glass are soothing, allowing the critical words to feel comforting. The sand begins to pile up, lifting the bottom to the top of the glass. The voice drops large blocks into the desert landscape, kicking the colors in all ways. They fall with precision, inches from your head. The impact shakes the glass. The glass reflects the desert sands back at you. Finally, the hourglass is flipped.